Hello everybody, welcome back to the channel. And if you're new, here we share good food from the Geordie kitchen. This is your weekly run through of everything we've been having for tea this week, starting from last Monday, going all the way through to Sunday. So this is last Monday, this is some steaks that we had in the fridge from Tesco, the medallion steaks, and I made that with some air-fried oven chips and air-fried onion rings, and it was very, very good. I just pan-fried the steak. I like mine medium. Lee likes his mooing. Let's just say that. And yeah, we had that with some lovely onion rings and some, well, I had some greens, Lee didn't. So if you're wondering about that lovely air fryer there, I have a video coming up for that. That was very, very kindly gifted to us by Kazori. And I will be reviewing, well, we've been playing with it really, we've been testing it out, trying different things, and we've made a nice video, and I will be reviewing that for you later this week, so watch out for that. This is some watercress that I've dressed with shallot and balsamic dressing, and it was very, very good. I like that on the side there, so we had that. That was Monday. Very, very good. So on to Tuesday, I made my quick tomato and bacon soup. This is the multi-cooker that I own. So I just bung everything in. This was some onions, some frozen onions, and a tin of chopped tomatoes. I like the mooty ones. And a carton of just plain passata with some seasoning, and I chucked a ham stock cube in there as well, and I just set it going for about 40 minutes. And this is really versatile, this recipe. Sometimes I add leeks, sometimes I add carrots, it's just what I have in. Sometimes I add lentils, which is really nice, makes it more substantial, especially in the winter. And while that's cooking in there, we just fry, you know, those little cubes of pancetta. Well, this is the smoked pancetta, and I just cooked both packets just in a pan there, just to brown them, and we like to add those at the end so we don't puree them away. And we had these Paul Hollywood ready to bake at home rolls. They're very good, these, they're very, very nice, so they just take 10 minutes as well. So at the end you just blitz it, or you can keep it whole if you like. We like to blitz ours. You could add a swirl of cream if you're serving this as well. You just ladle it into your bowls. We had loads left as well. We had it the next day for lunch. And then I just take that, some of that diced pancetta, and just top it. Sprinkle it on the top. And those lovely buns from the oven, which we've just split open and buttered. Nice and quick, hardly any effort as well, and it was delicious. So on to Wednesday, we had the grandchildren coming over to stay, so I decided to make something they like. I know they like chili, so, and I know they like the tater tots, so we made a chili tater tot bake casserole type of thing. So before we went to pick them up, I just set away a chili mix. This Old El Paso mix is delicious. I've since discovered it, and I think it's much, much better than the Coleman's one. There's a load of flavour in it. So I just made it like I make my ordinary chili, with some baked beans. And then I set that away, and then I went and picked the kids up, and then when we came back, we just put it in a dish. And then topped it with those tater tots, which were chili flavoured tater tots. I didn't even know I'd pick those up. I can't even remember where I got them. And then we just laid that up in the dish, put the tater tots on the top, and topped that with some grated cheddar. And that went in the oven for 40 minutes and it was all bubbly and crispy. It was delicious, really, really good. And the grandchildren just ate it up, clean plates. So as you know, we were going to York on the Thursday, so it was an early start for all of us. But I did make them dessert. I made them some warm cookie dough. That's just the sweet corn going on there, some buttered corn. I made them some warm cookie dough and some chocolate sauce for their pudding. So on to Thursday, where we went to York. This is in the food court just by the Shambles. And we found a little Italian place. There's the girls there waiting patiently for our food, bless her. And that's Olivia. And she got an arancino with cheese, I think it was cheese and ham inside, I can't remember. And she thought that was very, very good. Yeah, the little Italian place we found, it was a genuine Italian pizza place. Just a tiny little hole in the wall, and we found the pepperoni pizza and these crispy dessert lobster tail things. I've actually bought these before on Amazon and they're delicious. So we had a slice of pizza each, Lee and me. And I had the hazelnut one and he had the lemon lobster tail. So Georgia will be posting her version of the day. We went to the Dreamery fairy sanctuary and then to the Shambles. I'll put a little card just right there so you can go and check that out. And that's just the children in the enchanted forest there. And when we got back, we had some Cheesecake Guy pizza pizza on the brain, cheesecake, and I had the Snickers one this time and it was delicious, and some cake and cheese Wensleydale just for my supper. But you know, when you get back in, you just like a little bite when you've been traveling. So that was our tea / supper. It was quite late when we got back. So we are doing a giveaway. We bought some goodies in the Shambles and also the tea shop in York. That is a very, very good tea shop, Hebden Teas. So we'll be filming that very soon and doing the giveaway probably at the end of the week. So do watch out for that, because we've bought all of our stuff now. This is just the rum and raisin fudge that I picked for myself that night, so that's what we had. Now the next day, we didn't really feel like eating much over the weekend, because unfortunately Lee was mugged in a car park, in a shopping centre car park. He had his phone, his cards, his driving licence, everything was taken, and we just didn't feel like eating. So that was our breakfast that day, and that was my afternoon cake. But after it happened at about tea time, and when it happened, we felt sick. It was awful. So we haven't really been doing much over the weekend. I'm just recovering from it, really. It's nothing like this has ever happened to us before. So, you know, these things happen and we've cancelled everything and just getting on with it now. So this is Saturday. This is cake tea again. Hammond Branston. This is the small chunk Branston. We like that pickle and some Walker's cheese and onion. No cooking involved, just grabbing things out of the pantry, really. And this is a little cupcake that was left over from the children's sting, and an apple turnover because we couldn't get the raspberry ones, just left over for when the kids were here. So we just ate them up, just finished them off. So there was no cooking involved, just preparing. And this is Sunday. This is a Tesco ready meal. This is their chicken hot pot. And it was very good. I mean, needless to say, I had to pick all those peas out. But it was very, very nice. I did enjoy it. And I finished my meal that evening with just the rest of the fudge that I'd bought, the rum and raisin fudge. To be honest, I do like their clotted cream one better, and that's the one that is going to be in their hamper. So that's it from me this week. I hope you've enjoyed the meals of the week. We'll be back later in the week with the giveaway and the other Kasori air fryer review. So I'll leave you with some pics of the kids in the Enchanted Forest, and I'll see you very, very soon. Thanks for watching. Take care now. Bye-bye.
I went to Blade and Races, it was on the 9th of June, 1862 in a summer's afternoon. We took the bus for Bamborough's and she was heavy laden, and away we went along Collingwood Street, that's on the boat of Blade. And oh, lad, you should have seen us cannon, passing the folks upon the boat.